on this program, Overweight and Undernourished. In the United States, we've been hearing a lot about infrastructure, mostly because so much of our nation's infrastructure is slipping into disrepair. For a long time now, every incoming presidential administration promised to fix it. And to one degree or another, they all tried. But the deterioration continues. Our roads, tunnels, bridges, power grid, rail system, water and sewer systems, mass transit, communications networks, and even our modern information technology infrastructure are all suffering. The reason is not lack of funding. We throw tons of money into infrastructure, yet we don't build fast enough to meet our growing needs. And sadly, we can't even keep up with basic maintenance. Money does not solve everything. This problem is about something else. In the first chapter of Haggai, we hear God speaking through the prophet to the nation of Israel. Now therefore, says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. You have sown much and bring in little. You eat, but do not have enough. You drink, but you are not filled with drink. You clothe yourselves, but no one is warm. And he who earns wages to put into a bag with holes. That describes not only the United States, but much of the world today. We're swimming in one direction and being pulled by the current in the other direction. We may have lots of money, but there are holes in our pockets. No matter how much money we bring in, it disappears before our needs are met. It's never enough. Two national epidemics illustrate this problem: obesity and malnutrition. Obesity is especially prevalent among the poor. That sounds pretty good at first. Our poor are doing so well, they tend to be overweight. But it's an illusion. While we are one of the most obese nations in the history of the world, we are at the same time malnourished. In July 2018, the National Journal of Obesity published a study titled Overfed but Undernourished, recognizing nutritional inadequacies, deficiencies in patients with overweight or obesity. It said many people with obesity have inadequate intake of iron, calcium, magnesium, zinc, copper, folate, and vitamins A and B12. God says you eat, but do not have enough. You eat, but your food lacks proper nutrition. So even with your belly full, you're still hungry. And so you eat more. We have made a science of creating foods that seem to fill our body's cravings, but in fact only increase those cravings. It's a horrible irony. We're fat, but starving. Now, if you have a weight problem, I don't want you to feel bad. That's not what this is about. This is about a societal problem, and not really even about weight or nutrition, but those two things happening at the same time illustrate the real problem. Do you see what's happening? We eat and eat and eat, and yet we are malnourished. No matter how much we spend on infrastructure, it just keeps crumbling beneath our feet. Something's wrong. As a nation, we spend 18% of our gross domestic product on healthcare, yet with all the money spent and all the many breakthroughs in medical science, we're sicker and sicker, and every year we die younger and younger. This isn't about COVID. The downward trend in life expectancy began in 2015, well before COVID. Our pockets have holes, and our money keeps falling to the ground where it does us no good. Something's wrong. Maybe the problem is not just political. Maybe it's also spiritual. Maybe we're fooling ourselves to think that if we can just get the right person or the right people into office, then all will be well. Maybe we are the problem. Could it be that most of God's people, the people who are called by His name, have stopped making Him the priority in their lives? Have we allowed Satan to trick us into turning our priorities upside down? Are we like those ancient Israelis God spoke to through Haggai? God said to them, and I think he's saying to us, consider your ways. The old hymn says, he loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is due him. Do we search his word? Do we seek his wisdom? Tell the truth? Hold fast to his definitions of right and wrong? Do we reach out to the hurting? Do we feed the hungry? Do we feed them with that which truly nourishes? Every Christian must ask, is the Lord truly Lord in my life? Thank you for watching. God willing, I'll see you soon.